Hi Capricorn, welcome to SylphQuest, I'm Spence. Welcome back if you're a subscriber and welcome into the channel if you're new. I'm so glad that you stopped by. All right, so this is gonna be a weekly reading for August 9th, yes, through the 15th. And we just came off of that new moon, that Leo new moon and Lionsgate at 8-8, right? On the 8th. So we're still starting the week with that energy. New beginning, something auspicious and interesting might be coming in with that Lionsgate energy. I love that for us. If you did not hear the message from last week, that Lionsgate message were, I think all of those were pretty cool, so you might want to listen so you have a reference. Now, I do want to say that we are also going to have a second Aquarian full moon coming up in a couple weeks from that new moon. So I say, I think, I don't know, 22nd, 3rd, or 4th. I'm sorry, I don't have it in front of me. I think it might be the 24th. We're going to have a second Aquarian full moon. And so in this entire month of Leo, this entire season, it is very much about that letting go process, the change, the radical changes that are being made in our lives, sometimes with some really surprising news coming in, right? So yeah, having to go with the flow. That's what's going on. Now, right now, I am laying out your new Paladini tarot, your 9-card spread from that tarot deck. And then I'm going to pull one of the Kim Cran's Wild Unknown Archetypes. Okay? And I'll read one of those for you. So those are the decks I'm using today. And I just shuffled, as you saw, and cut the deck. And I'm laying out your 9 cards. So while I'm doing this, if you would settle in with me now. All right, Capricorn, and then we are going to read from the book for you. So take a couple of deep cleansing breaths and tell yourself, you know, I'm going to relax. Settle in. Take some time just for me. Bring down the cortisol, right? Get some oxygen to the brain. Lift up the serotonin and dopamine. Makes you feel so much better when you do. All right, very good. And now I'm gonna pull one of these for you while I'm looking at your spread. Oop! Fell right on the floor, but I think there was more than one. Yep, more than one. You need just one. All right, so let's shuffle them up a little more while I'm looking at your spread. Interesting. So you're moving forward. I think that new moon's going to bring you an aha. And maybe you didn't want to see it, but you realize something that is going to help you move forward from negative things that have been going on or people. I think you've wanted very much to work with others. I just don't know whether or not you've been able to, for whatever reason, if they've been on board with you. And so I think you're trying to motivate someone, or you're trying to like ask for help. Maybe somebody's been very stuck in their head and they just haven't been able to get on board. But okay, there we go. We have the Forest. All right, the Forest. That's the card that wanted to come out for you. So let me pull that up and we'll take a listen and see what this might be about. So, how are you? How are you doing, Capricorn? You might want to leave me a message. Let me know what's going on with you. Okay. The Forest. Here's your card. Ready? The woods, the thicket, the jungle. Consider for a moment your earliest memory of the forest. It's likely that it included all the mythic dynamics of this archetypal space. Maybe a little fear, a little enchantment, perhaps losing your way, perhaps discovering a secret mystical treasure. Such is the magic of the forest. It requires first that you enter it, and then that you get lost within it. You may think there's a path to lead you straight through, but soon enough you'll be on what is known as the pathless path. There are tricksters there, dense foliage and entanglement, but equally present are the glimmers of fairy light and friends among the trees. You are on an adventure now, and there's no turning back. So embrace the dim light and the moving shadows, whether literal or imaginal. Brave the forest and get lost, getting found. Wow. So an adventure, maybe, you know, eliciting a bit of fear, most certainly wonder, maybe a little bit of trepidation, but also excitement. It's a little bit of all of that, isn't it? When we are in a time that feels so dense that we can't quite see our way through, and it makes sense that during these Uranian Shakanam changing things in our lives, that we do feel a bit lost, you know? But somewhere in that we get found, because somewhere in there we realize, we find ourselves. We realize where we stand. Where do we stand in life? Where do we stand in the things that we're thinking? Where do we stand in the way that we're feeling? Where do we stand with what we want? Because when you're a bit lost, you realize what feels like home to you. Because only then do you miss home and understand then what home feels like for you and what you want to get back to. But also, why you got lost there in the first place. Was it outer circumstances? Did you take the trip? And, you know, did you go on a journey looking for something different, something new? And in that, what did you find? And, you know, is it leading you back home, or is it leading you on through the forest to a new place? So these might be questions, because you're looking at your future with the Three of Wands, the Three of Rods in this deck. And this is a fire card. It's the element of fire, and it's about what we want, what we expect. We've put stuff out there, and we're waiting to see what's going to happen now. Right? It's like you've taken a couple of steps forward, and now the ships are coming in. What is the result of what you've been doing? Well, something, because there's a change happening with the Wheel of Fortune. The timing is now, and I think it might actually really surprise you with the Tower. This is a shock, a surprise, an aha moment. It's something that is like a lightning strike. And I've been saying that within this whole Leo season, it feels like that, especially now at the new moon with Lionsgate. And here I'm seeing it too in your first row, because this, by the way, is what's under the deck in your subconscious, right? It's like you're expecting some change to happen and happen now. But you just don't know how it's going to happen or exactly what. You know that it might really be surprising, okay? So it's kind of like get yourself prepared for anything. Right, Capricorn, which means just go with the flow of what happens and allow for the changes to move you forward. And that's what's happening here. The Six of Swords is when we get in a boat and we move forward away from choppy waters to smoother waters. So yeah, there was something, you know, that you were trying to move forward from, something that didn't feel good, something that felt uncomfortable. Maybe working with your own desires, your own needs, your own ego, possibly, something to do with trying to build a life that you're comfortable in with people that you're comfortable with and not having it be so hard, so difficult, because the Six of Swords is about moving forward from conflict. And I think you're able to do that because you got this truth, this aha moment. The Ace of Swords is a truth, it's knowledge, it's absolute clarity, it's a lightning strike. Ah, now I see. So I'm moving forward now because I see now where I didn't see before. This can also happen because we have a conversation. When two swords are crossed, it's usually we're in two minds or it's two people having two differing opinions and we can't make a choice because do I listen to myself or do I listen to them? So it can be an impasse. But then when you come to clarity and you make a decision, then you can move forward. And that's what I'm seeing. You move forward because you come to clarity. You're able to make a decision. You're able to see the truth of what it is that you want to do or need to do to move forward, okay? With the Three of Pentacles, you're building something here that you care very much, stands the test of time. It comes from deep inside of you. There's a wise part of yourself that knows deep down what you really want. What you really want with the Nine of Cups. What would fulfill you? What makes you happy? And with the High Priestess, we don't always say it out loud. You know, it's something we know intuitively, we feel, but we don't necessarily share it. We can very often keep it quiet. And with the Two of Swords up in the row above it, I don't know that you have been talking about it, but maybe you've needed to. Maybe you've needed to ask for what you want and need. With this, it's Cups card. It's water. It's emotional. It's what we really need to feel happy. And maybe you haven't been speaking up. That's kind of what I'm seeing. And I think you're telling yourself the truth about that now. You're like, you know what? In order for me to have the future I want, the change that I want, I may have to really surprise someone and come out with something and say it out loud because I want to build a life together with this person. That's what I really want. It's just right now, you know, I'm still telling myself what I want. I'm still learning it for myself with the Ace of Swords above it. It's like you're just realizing it. Oh, okay, I thought this is what I needed to make me happy, but really, maybe I realized actually what really does make me happy is something different. And it's time to say it out loud. So you don't hold yourself back anymore. You let the lion roar a little bit, or at least purr, during Leo season. Leo the lion. During this season right now, you have the guts, the strength, the bravery to say it. Because you don't want to feel this way about your life, lackluster, uninterested, or unfulfilled when you can be happy and fulfilled. A closed mouth doesn't get fed, right? So you can't keep it inside in your head anymore. You've gone round and round thinking about it. It's time to make the decision. So let's go down the vertical and I'll show this to you in another way. Six of Swords, you're moving forward from the conflict of keeping it in and then expecting somebody else to read your mind, maybe. I'm just saying, if it's possible. If it's not you, it's maybe someone you're dealing with. But that's what I'm seeing. So in order to move forward together and help each other out, to build the life that you want to live, a life that is a sanctuary for everyone, where you can all just be lost in it and found in it. Seeing the forest for the trees, then it takes guts. It takes real bravery, real courage to move forward and change something and say it out loud. Say, look, if we just do this and we change something or we move, this can be traveling, moving forward, traveling somewhere in order to build a new house, build a new life together. You're going to have to be brave and say it out loud. Right? She's holding that lion's mouth closed in this picture. So this Ace of Swords is tell the truth and have the conversation, because keeping it quiet, everything inside of you that you know, that you know, that you know that you want, it's not inspiring you. It's not leaving you happy and fulfilled. It's leaving you in a state of apathy and disinterest, and you don't want to feel this way anymore. You may be stable where you are, it may feel less risky, but it's certainly not inspiring and it's certainly not fulfilling. So instead, it's saying have the conversation and open up about it, okay? Because the High Priestess is the center card of your reading today, which means intuitively, instinctively, in the marrow of your bones, you have a deep wisdom knowing the truth that you have not been feeling inspired or really happy. And you, in order to move yourself toward that, you need to do something brave. It's time for you to come out of this, because in order to get your wish and be happy and be fulfilled, you have to open these swords up. right? Because if you're staying in your head, confused about what to do, will they, he loves me not, she loves me not, you know, are they, will they be open to moving? Would they be open to me changing jobs, trying on a new career, or whatever it is that you're going back and forth over, it's something you need to talk about, because keeping it in your head is going to drive you nuts, right? When you go around and around in circles, it cages you in, and it makes your whole life feel like a cage. So this is definitely saying to open those swords, take the blindfold off, see it for what it is, speak the truth, and allow for the other opinion as well. So when we open up, we each can say our piece, and both move forward together, helping each other out. I think you've really felt stuck. And, you know, there's cabin fever here as well, right? There's cabin fever. I think you're ready for this change. No, it's like, just bring it, universe, because I'm just lost here. And life has become too dense. I look to the left, I see trees. I look to the right, I see trees. I look behind me, I see trees. I don't, you know, and you've lost the ability maybe to ask for your direction from the internal and then allow yourself with courage to speak it out to the person external to you, to whomever is in your life. There's someone here in your life. There's someone in this boat with you, and there's someone you're building this life with. So there, your joy is here. And your apathy will go as soon as you get out of your head and say it out loud. Okay? I get it. This takes courage. And sometimes people might be shocked. Someone might be shocked, Capricorn, by whatever it is that you want to say or announce. But you found yourself in the quiet, in the dark of the forest. You realize what you don't really want or what you can't really do anymore. Okay? And you're ready for the new. You're ready. You are. So, you can say it out loud. All right, Capricorn, I wish you kindness, reverence, and gratitude. Thank you so much for coming by today, and I'll be here for you next week. Click on that little eye up there if you're interested in your any other readings for the week. All right, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. It's all there. Thank you so much. I'll talk to you soon.